This is the fall show for the Oregon Modeler Society. For a lot of people, there's a nostalgia factor. Most of us grew up building models as a kid because the 60s and 70s were the heyday of model making in America. A lot of kids did it for a few years, and then you go to high school, you start meeting girls, driving real cars, you fall away from the hobby, but it never really leaves you. So a lot of people end up coming back to it later in life when they're approaching retirement, or when they have a little more time on their hands after their kids are grown. There's an ebb and flow to it for sure, but we're witnessing kind of a slight renaissance right now.
I've always loved miniatures ever since I was a little guy. I love, be it military, I build tank models and cars and everything too. It's really cool. There's so much artwork to apply to a miniature. And you learn so many techniques. You use painting, there's building, there's everything. It's really cool that you can have a little representation of a character from a movie that you love sitting on your shelf looking awesome at you. Or a car that you've always, I can't afford a Bentley from the 1915. I'd love to, But I can build a model of one. They're fun. It keeps you out of trouble, that's for sure, too.
The fascination of actually building something that represents a piece of history or a piece of technology, a favorite airplane, a favorite ship, and putting it together and painting it and assembling it and is actually the fun part, because after all, once it's done, it just sits on a shelf.
It is a quiet, solitary hobby, which in this day and age, that's kind of a rare thing. People like being quiet and being focused and being very interactive with something that's physical. It's almost a form of meditation for a lot of us.
I'm trying to make my very first custom.
Young people in modeling nowadays, most of us who grew up with modeling had an association with the subject, meaning we had parents or relatives who were in World War II, so they were on this specific plane. We had some sort of connection historically to the subjects that were being built. Nowadays, a lot of kids don't have a connection to the military side of model building. The younger people are all doing science fiction. A lot of Star Wars kits are spectacularly built these days. We also see a lot of Gundam, which is a Japanese robot series that was popular in the 70s and has steamrollered the model building industry in Japan.
What's great about these is, when you're doing cars, you're doing tanks, airplanes, any of that stuff, it's about accuracy, historical accuracies especially. A lot of these, you can paint a bear whatever color you want, no one's going to yell at you if it's a different color than the box. Or same with the Gundams, it can be any color you want it to be. It doesn't have to be realistic because it's science fiction to begin with. So I think that's one of the things that's more appealing, is it's more customizable. That's what it's about, I think, and that's what's more appealing. Especially nowadays, people want to customize their cell phones, they want to do their nails, people got colored hair. I think it's more fun, people get to make it their own. And I think that's what's one of the more appealing parts of it.
I would entice people to come to the shows, even if they're not interested in models. I mean, the entry fee is only $5 per person. Just come in, look around, and look at the magnificence of the work that's done here. It's three-dimensional art. It's what it is. And people need to come and see it. And who knows? You may get hooked.